guys. AJ Changes back here again with that week 10 update. I'll say real quick, if you find yourself enjoying these videos and you want to keep track of how I'm going and my progress, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. But that being said, let's get right into that weigh-in. So, 385. I'm happy with that. You know, like I said, it is more than what I was. I was 383 at my lowest, but recent lowest. And I'm pretty close to it, 2 pounds away. I'm not sweating it. I did figure out, I know I was talking about in my last video, what I was trying to think of what I was gonna do. And what I found was I was having a lot of trouble with consistency. Getting back into the groove of stuff is always a little bit difficult. I was, like I said, eating good in the mornings, and then towards the end of the days, I would fall off and start eating whatever I want or binging at night. And then even with my exercising. So I'm a person that doesn't mind fasting. Fasting doesn't affect me when it comes to, like, you know, getting headaches and stuff like that. I'm actually pretty good with fasting. So what I decided to do was go back to my old faithful, which is ADF, alternate day fasting. And at least yesterday when I ate, because it was my eating day, I went ahead and implemented o.m.a.d 2, which is 1 meal a day. So I fasted Monday. Yesterday I ate 1 meal, which is just eating whatever I want. It's not nothing in particular. It's just basically, I mean, I can eat whatever I want. I ate spaghetti and thinking two tacos, like chicken tacos. And then this morning I weighed myself, 385. So far this week I've lost 4 pounds. So it's been going pretty good, and it was pretty easy too. And what I will say is, if you are a person that doesn't do good when you don't eat, like say you skip breakfast and you get halfway through your day and you're feeling sick already, maybe fasting might not be for you. It's always good to try, so if that's something you want to try, go ahead and do it. But yeah, like I said, for me it's easy, so I went ahead and did that. It might sound drastic to some people, but I have other stuff to keep me occupied during my fasting times, so it's not too bad. But I mean, it's a pretty good number to me. I'm happy to see that. If I get underneath 73, that will be the lowest I've been in like the last 5 years. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'm 12 pounds away. And I guess I'll keep it short and simple, guys. It hasn't been that long. I know this is a very short video, but I have a special video coming Saturday, which if you're on a diet, which I assume most people are, and I guess I am too, even though it's more so a way of eating, you might not want to see what I'm gonna make on Saturday for my what I eat in a day video. It's gonna be what I'm eating on Thursday, because it's just easier to do it that way to make sure I get the video out for Saturday. So I'm planning on making me something that's gonna be not really a cheat meal, but it's gonna be unhealthy. If you're on a normal diet, it would be a cheat meal. So, but you can always, I'll give like tips and stuff on how you can make it better. It won't be a cooking video, but it'll be a, you know, what I eat in a day, and I'll explain a little bit on how I do it and what recipes I use and stuff. So hopefully you stick for that, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Like I always say, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you dislike it, give it a thumbs down, but let me know why in the comments, because I'm always trying to make these videos better. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.